Hello everyone, many of you asked me like what is the time to pay back loan after I study master's abroad. So this video will give you an approximate idea of the range of time that you need to pay back your education loan that you have taken in India for study abroad. The use case that I'll be using in this video is of the Netherlands for study and living, all types of expenses. While the same logic obviously can be adapted, what I mentioned in this video, for other European countries or US, for example. So the use case here takes an example of a very simple loan scheme, because nowadays, as you know, there are different institutions, different banks, government banks, private institutions, which can lend you education loan, and also the conditions, criteria, the terms and conditions, everything vary. So we will take a very simple example of taking a loan from a reputed government bank like SBI, State Bank of India. And let's consider that they have a very simple moratorium scheme, moratorium period and scheme to pay back loan. So for example, you might have like an interest-free period during the moratorium period, which is ideally, if you take a simple use case, will be like 2 years, suppose masters, and then 6 months. And after that, you start paying back loan. Till that time, you don't pay an interest or you only pay simple interest. So we will take that example. Like suppose you don't pay any interest during your study and you start immediately to pay back. Then what are the main components that you should know before you go into the calculation or the calculator to calculate your time to pay back the loan? I said, again, this is obviously dependent on the conditions, interest rate, flexibility offered by your financial institution or any bank. So first, let's consider the first point. What are the study and living expenses? So approximately with the current Indian rupees to euro rates, it's much higher. And you know, the education expenses here without scholarship can be very expensive. So if you consider the living and education together, I have made many videos on that, like what are the education expense and living expense. You can check these three videos flashing on the screen. You can also read a blog on this. I have written a blog on my website. You can also go through that to get a real good idea very quickly in 2-3 minutes, whatever I'm saying in the video along with the links. So approximately it will be 45 lakhs Indian rupees without any funding based on the current euro rates. And next question comes to your mind is, what is the education loan amount that I can take? Whatever I talked with few people who have already repaid the loan or they're repaying the loan, based on my experience and others' experience, I think the ideal amount is somewhere around 20 lakhs INR. But sometimes people may also take something like 30 lakhs INR. So I have taken little bit above average amount, which is like 30 lakhs Indian rupees. And if you take that, and if I go to the SBI website, the link of which will be in the description of the video and also in the blog. So then I see that on 28th August 2021, when I'm recording this video, there's 9.3% education loan rate, which is mentioned on the website. I think that is also negotiable, because I heard from some of my friends that it can also go as low as 8.2 or 8.5. But let's take what is in the website, the max thing, so that you also know like what is in the worst case, how much can you expect to repay. And then we use the EMI calculator to calculate. So before moving to the EMI calculator, the next question is, what is the average salary that you can expect? So average salary can be somewhere between 2,200 to 2,500 euro per month after taxes if you're a PhD, and if you're doing a job, then it can vary between 2,300 euros to 2,700 euros per month after taxes without any work experience. With work experience, it might be a bit higher. You can check my salary video, which will give a very nice idea, where I show all my pay slips that I get every year, every month, to give an idea about the salary that you can get. Then comes the next question, like how much can I save before I move to the EMI calculator, which is the main part of the video. So approximately, if I say in the worst case also, as a single person, you can easily save more than 50% of what you earn in a month. So you can check my savings video to get a detailed idea about the breakdown of different expenses. It will be flashing somewhere on the screen. So in the worst case, I'm taking the worst case to give an example of whatever worst scenario can you expect. Suppose you are doing a PhD, you are in the first year, suppose you are earning something like 2,200 euros per month. the lowest salary, let's take into account, and suppose you save the least, which is like 50% of 2200, so then it will be somewhere around 1100 euros. Then go to this website. You might see a screenshot on the screen. You can automatically calculate using this EMI calculator, and as I understand, if I'm not wrong, if you use the calculator and enter the principal, so in this case, let's take principal, as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, 30 lakhs INR, and we take a 3-year payback period, so which obviously starts after your study because you don't pay any interest in the moratorium period, the simple use case. And if you take 9.3% per annum interest rate, with all the compounding and everything, it shows that the easy monthly installment EMI for 3 years, if you want to pay back in 3 years, will be somewhere around 95,819 rupees, so which is somewhere around on the current rate of 28th August 2021 to INR to euro is somewhere around 1105 euros. So it's very near to your worst savings, which is 1100. So I think you can also maybe pay back if you have a better job or more savings, which you obviously will have. Even if you don't have a better job, if you're doing a PhD, you will have more savings as a single person. Then you can easily pay back within 3 years. So the point that I'm trying to make is, even with high living expenses and study expenses here, it is worth the return on investment, the ROI, that you can easily pay back within 3 years, even in the worst case scenario. So yeah, that's the point I wanted to make. I hope that this video helped you a lot to understand about different what is the time that is necessary to pay back the loan after master study abroad. And please share this video, help each other out. Don't forget to check the blog link also in the description below. Share this video, subscribe to the channel. Till then, peace. Next video, bye.